So, you can just use the exact example from yesterday. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and exactly like yesterday, I'm going to call this first ordered pair x1, y1, and this second ordered pair x2, y2, and use slope formula. Say you did slope formula? What do you have? 209 over 2?
I'm sorry.
Is it 209 over 2? Okay, so does anybody understand what this means with regards to the problem? It says a homeowner charges a processing fee and a daily fee to rent a house. The table shows the total cost of renting a house for different numbers of days. What does the 104.50 stand for? Anybody? What does this number mean with those words? Yeah, it's a slope, but what's it mean for the house? Cost per day. It's $104.50 per day. You guys probably have no idea how much it costs to rent a house, but like this is talking about like Airbnb. That's what we're looking at. Airbnbs, you'll look and they seem so inexpensive and cheap, and then you go to check out. And then all of a sudden, their cleaning fee and their processing fee varies a lot. So you have no idea how much it costs until you hit checkout. It's really annoying, actually. All right, so now we'll do point slope form. And so I'm going to, again, it's y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. So I'm going to use this y1 and this x1. $104.50 to rent the house for one day, but we don't know what the processing fee is yet. Once we do this, we'll see that processing fee. Jason, did you do point slope form? Or did you use slope intercept form? $104.50 times 2. It's not B yet. Not until I move this 258 over.
Oh, you want to find by 2. I thought you put that in my
game. No, I'm using that point slope from yesterday. This is 49. Okay, so I could plug in any number of days to this equation, and it would tell me, you know, how much my vacation is going to cost if I want to do that Airbnb. So this is the answer to number one, and all of that work is required. So now that we have this equation, we can see the processing fee. The processing fee is the $49, and then the slope is how much it costs. Number two says if a renter has $1,200, how many days can they go for? Where should we plug $1,200 in? Should we go in the Y spot or the X spot? So $1,200 is the amount they have to pay. And the question is, how many days? So, what is X in the table? What does X represent? Okay, so that means we're looking for X. That means how many X? If we're looking for how many days and phase is X, we're looking for X. So, $1,200, the amount they can pay, is our Y value. So, put $1,200 in for Y, and you'll be able to find how many days they can stay.
Hope they can stay for a whole week. Have a great time. At the beach.
With their $1,200. Let me subtract that 49 from both sides. Okay, well, let's take the
processing fee out of here. And then we'll divide by the cost per day, and that'll tell us how many days. A lot of people do that just thinking about it. And I'm going to go off a little bit. Here's the equation that a business would use to make long-term decisions.
About the days.
Let's answer in a complete sentence. A nice complete sentence would say, with $1,200, $1,200 they can rent for 11 days.
You also could just say 104 times a number plus 49.
And that's what most people would do in their lives. Most people aren't using the whole equation in their lives. But businesses, on a business scale, if a company has to rent buildings and they have $1,200 per location, they're not going to keep calculating.
So, well, the book keeps trying to make these seem like problems that you would do in real life. It's really much more applicable to businesses and accounting and management. So,
okay, let's look at homework.
Stuff on the right side.
Same.
Yeah, we do. Yeah, every night. Wait, so I write this?
You don't have to. If you want to spend your time checking homework instead, that's really good.
Alright. Or just write the beat.
And
clear
your
call
for the I did 1 minus negative 2. And the minus and negative turns to a plus. Oh my gosh, it's 1/2. What do you have on your? So problem says 16. What are you saying? We did 17 in class. I'm not showing that one. 6, negative 2, 12, 1. Sure. There's 18 and 19. Are you guys correcting? You said you were confused on 19. Are you making corrections?
I don't have this.
Okay, any questions on these before I go to 20?
Yes, I was in the house.
Where do you get sick? Are you good? Have you just done it in All right, we're jumping to, so this is from 4.2, we're going to 4.2, talking about parallel and perpendicular lines.
Miss, how you got?
I got a handout for you to take no time.
You got 15.
So 3 over 5 times 5.
Negative 3
right here. I just wrote a middle step. This is negative 3, right?
Why'd you vote that so negative
3? Well, I find that for students who aren't good at fractions, that they understand this better. Because it's
3
times
5
is
15,
and 5 times 6 is 5.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you're timing them?
And
that's
negative 0.
Oh, okay.
I'm going to have to put that yesterday.
I'm being a preferred option there,
That's cool.
Can you read that?
Yeah.
All right, if you guys could on here, write chapter 4.4, so you know, like, where this is in the book. Parallel and perpendicular lines.
Yeah.
Right. You've probably already worked with parallel perpendicular lines before. So let's just go around the room and read this. So what's in this first yellow box, Gavin? Alright, same slope and different y-intercepts is what we're going to look for parallel lines. Same slope and different y-intercepts.
Parallel?
Yeah, parallel. So parallel means they run side by side and they never touch. They never cross. Yeah, so this is how a lot of people think of parallel lines, straight up and down, but they can be like at an angle. Okay, so these are all considered parallel. Parallel at an angle, parallel up and down, parallel horizontally.
Okay, next box, Maya.
Next box.
Notice you see the definition. Same slope. So you don't need to be given a picture to identify lines as parallel.
If they have the same m value, that means they are parallel.
Well, they only show the y value.
So look. This, you don't see a slope, but you have to know going into the problem that this is a no-slope line. So if both equations are no-slope, that means they're up and down, undefined, I should say, on all undefined lines are parallel. No-slope and undefined. You guys write the difference here. This one's called undefined, and this one's called no-slope. They are all parallel. It doesn't matter where they are. All undefined lines are parallel, and all no slope lines are parallel. All
right, our next box says identify which lines are parallel and explain why. So I want to be able to compare these two. But you cannot compare if they're not in the same form. And typically the form we're looking for is y equals mx plus b.
So this one, I'm ready to start comparing. On this one, I can see the slope. The slope is 2. But what's the slope on this one? I have no idea what the slope is on that one.
That's as big as I can get it. If you want to come up here, you can.
All right, so I can't make a question with you, so we can make a decision about that second equation. We have to move it.
To rearrange it so we can see a slope-intercept form. So you gotta isolate y so you can find m. Not to find m. So we're gonna rearrange. We wanna rearrange so y equals m. So many options, like you guys might do it in 3 different ways and be able to do it. I'm going to go about it what I think is the easiest way. I would leave y right here. I'm going to leave that there. I'm going to put a line in and I'm going to move everything away from there. So I would subtract 2x. There's one more thing we have to do. We have to divide by negative 1 to really get y alone.
Because variables can't be negative?
They can, but it wouldn't be considered isolated. It's not slope intercept form until y is absolutely alone. So, this problem would have been easier if they would have just given us the equation in the right form. So this equation is actually y equals 2x minus 5. So yes, it is parallel. This given equation is parallel to this one rewritten.
So even if one is positive and one is negative, they're still parallel?
No, they have to both be positive. So in my mind, those are the positive two.
Because you already
know. Yeah, I divided by negative 1 before I decided. Alright, our next slide. We need to write an equation of a line that goes through this point. I'm going to call that point x1 and y1. And it's parallel to 3x plus 8.
Sorry.
No. So I'm going to use m equals 3. Why am I using m equals 3? So in order to achieve this mission, I'm going to use m equals 3 because I want it parallel to this, so it'll have to have the same slope as this line. And I'm going to use point slope form with the point they've asked me to have my line go through.
So this is directly related to yesterday's lesson.
Go ahead and rearrange it. Now we have a parallel line. Remember the definition of parallel lines? Same slope, different y-intercepts.
The slope of the given one was 3, and the slope of the one I just wrote is 3. The y-intercept I've given is 8, and the y-intercept I just wrote is negative 5. So those are parallel lines.
We're going to skip that last. And we're going to talk about perpendicular. What do you guys even know about perpendicular? Yes.
Two lines that intersect
in a very specific way, they make a 90 degree angle. Perpendicular lines would be a perfect 90 degree angle, right? So now we're going to make equations of perpendicular lines. Any questions on this last thing we did before I move on to perpendicular?
Which is the plus x? See the y equal 3x plus 8.
The purpose? It says write an equation that passes through this point and is parallel to this.
So the m3 is equal to
m2. Yeah. Well, that would be the y-intercept. And for them to be parallel, they have to have different y-intercepts.
Oh, okay.
Great question. All right, let's get somebody else to read. I think we're on Brayden. Brayden, you read this one. Opposite reciprocal. Okay, let me give you an example. So here's a fraction.
3 over 4. A perpendicular slope, like if that was a slope. Opposite reciprocal. Reciprocal flips it. So it would be 4 over 3. Opposite changes the sign. So it's negative 4 over 3. So to create an opposite reciprocal, you flip the fraction and change the sign. You have to do both or it won't be perpendicular.
Which question?
I just made that one.
Also.
This is an example. So I like this little picture here, but I'm going to have to put in at least one 90 degree symbol. You guys know this means 90 degrees, right?
So I got to put that in there to prove it's perpendicular. This as well. So an undefined slope and a no slope are also perpendicular lines. So here, these are perpendicular. If you look at the slopes in this box, let's take a look. In the top, the m value is negative 2 over 1. You don't see the 1, but there's an invisible 1 there.
So perpendicular is positive 1 half.
This one's a positive 1 half, and that's a negative 2 over 1.
So it's an opposite sign and it's flipped. Opposite reciprocal. Alright, what's the slope of this equation here?
Slope of that in that red box.
Mm-hmm. So in that first equation, it means 1/2. If 1/2 is in the y spot, what's the slope of the second equation? I don't know. That one has to be rearranged. You guys try to rearrange this one on your own before I do. It looks exactly like this.
It's gonna be y equals 2x over 3 once you divide everything by negative 1.
So that second equation, the m value is a positive 2. Would those be considered perpendicular lines?
No.
Are there slopes for reciprocals? Yes. Are they opposite? No. One has to be positive and one has to be negative. So these are not perpendicular. These two are yes perpendicular. That's because one is a no slope and one is an undefined. Alright, this is the last problem we're going to do on this handout. And then I want to show you what the upward looks like. Write an equation of a line that passes through the point, so I'm going to label point of x1, y1, and it's perpendicular to, alright, so guys, look, so given is m equals 4 over 5. So if I was doing parallel, I would use 4 over 5. But I'm doing perpendicular. What slope should I use? Annalise, you know?
No.
Negative 5 over 4. So in my point slope form, I'm using negative 5 over 4.
Where did you get that from?
I flipped it, and I made the sign opposite.
Why?
Because that's the definition of perpendicular.
To flip it.
And make an opposite sign.
Is this on the board?
Opposite and same.
So in order for a line to be perpendicular to y plus 1 equals 4 5. To that one, the slope has to be perpendicular.
Yeah.
Okay, alright, then.
So that's x1, y1, and we're going to do the slope, negative 5 over 4. I don't know.
What if there's something wrong?
I'm doing point slope form with that information, with that point, and with that slope. More and more fraction work each day. Negative 5 over 4 times negative 4, no big deal. Just do the 5
times the 4 is 20, and the denominator stays 4. There is a perpendicular line to the one that was given. When you're ready, you can start looking at your homework assignment, which is
So, can I have the test? Can I start it right now? Yeah, I feel good today.
Take a look at 1, 3, and 5. They look totally different than what we just did.
Page 341.
1, 3, 5, 9, 10.
Thank you. I mean, when I really look at it, they all look parallel, don't they? You think the green one looks a little bit different?
Miss, what makes a function a function?
Well, I've already kind of gone through it, but what, like, what specifically makes a function? Like that it has to have a slope? Or do the lines have to be straight?
I think green is the one that's going to
So when I did like slope formula on the green, which is called letter C, I got 3 over 5, and I can just count rows over red, right? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and that checks out. So I'm going to count rows over red again for the red one. And the red one looks like up 1, 2, over 1, 2, 3. So while they appear to say they are different, let me check in now. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. So I'm going to go ahead and say that the blue and the red are parallel. Yep, line A and B are parallel. So when you do 3, you have to do slope formula 3 times to compare slopes. When you do 5, you have to rearrange, like we practiced in class, to y equals mx plus b prime. You have to rearrange all 3 of them so that you can see the m. You compare. If they have the same m, they're parallel. If they don't, they're not.
Teacher, please press the interruption for 0.
What makes the function of the
drive? The rules of function is for each x and the
third
of the third. Yes, you need to remind her that the response is today, 7108.